Welcome everybody. You are seeing some component. I will show the use of multimeter for this component. I have two resistance. One resistance is very high value, more than 2 mega ohms. Another is very small value. When we measure high value and low value resistor, we have to keep some precautions. Those precautions I will tell. Then I have one signal diode, then I have another power supply diode, then there are three LEDs. These are small size LEDs, this is big 5mm LEDs, this is green color LED. So for this 5 LEDs and diodes, two diodes and three LED, I will measure the diode drop. Because forward drop depends upon the current, I will use two multimeter. One multimeter will measure the current, at what current diode drop is being measured, and other will show the diode drop. Then I have two transistors, one is NPN, one is PNP. In this also there is a diode inside, this is BE, that I will measure, and then HFE also I will measure. This much will be shown today. Now I have with me two resistors. One, this is high value, this is more than 2 mega ohm. This is very low value, about 2 ohm. First I will measure 2 mega ohm and see what is the problem. See here. This is showing and this is changing. What happens? Here I have some body resistance. See, at 2 mega ohm setting I will keep. So this body resistance, which is about 1 mega ohm, will come in parallel of this 2 mega ohm. So it will measure parallel resistance. So to measure this resistance properly of high value, I will set again scale of 20 mega. One side we can touch the resistor, other side we cannot touch. We have to keep like this. Then the correct value will come. It's showing 2.35. If we do like this, then body resistance also will come, it will show low value, it is giving error. So we have to see like this, we have to measure like this, or we can keep on the floor or some place and press like this and measure. So it will come whatever 2.34 mega ohm is coming. Now you know the problem with high value resistor, body resistance the problem. Body should not touch, one side you can touch, other side you cannot touch. Now we will see what is the problem with low value. This is 2 ohm. So I will keep scale of the multimeter at 200 ohm. That is the lowest value I have. Now I will measure again. It is showing 3 ohm. But before that, we have to clean this lead. There will be a dust. Because your resistance value is very low, so dust may create some problem. I have already cleaned. Now you see here, it is coming 2.9 ohm. Now if I remove the resistor and short this lead, it is showing 0.6 ohm. This 0.6 ohm is the resistance of this lead, which is always added to resistor. When resistor value is small, this 0.6 ohm will add to 3 ohm, so error will be very high. So when resistor value is small, how we will measure? First we will measure like this 2.8 ohm, then we will measure like this 0.6 ohm. This 0.6 ohm we will subtract from this 2.8 ohm. So resistance value is not 2.8 ohm. Resistance value is 2.8 minus 0.6 is equal to 2.2 ohm. So this is the problem of measuring low value resistance. I have a signal diode with me. This is 4148. Right side there is a black, left side is a red. This red side is anode. This anode we connect with red color wire. Not common, this is this side, and cathode we connect to this black color, and this scale we keep at diode. This is diode. So at diode we have kept my scale and will measure. It is showing millivolt. Now diode drop is 600 millivolt. But now current we cannot see at what current it is measuring. So I will connect a multimeter also and see this drop is coming at what current. This is set up. I have two multimeter. One is set for diode, other for milliampere. This is connected in series of diode. This positive is connected to anode. The cathode goes to common and this circuit completes. So this in series. So this will measure milliampere, this will measure diode drop. And here I will keep my diode, whichever diode I want to test. I have a signal diode with me, 4148. Will measure the drop. The diode drop comes, forward drop, 690 millivolt at current 0.98 milliampere. If you measure reverse, it will show open. This means the diode is okay. Now I will take another diode. This is 4007 used in rectifier. It has a ring here wide. This side that is cathode and this side is anode. So anode is connected to positive. The drop is 668 millivolt at the current of 0.99 milliampere. If you measure reverse, it will show open. It looks like diode is okay. But what happens, the diode is designed by 1000 volt peak. Sometimes there will be a partial failure. This means diode will work at low voltage, but more than 100 volt or 200 volt if you give, diode will fail. That we cannot make out using this method. Now I will take LED. LED has two terminal. One is longer, one is shorter. Longer is anode. The longer one will connect with red wire. This will connect. This LED is glowing. Forward drop is 1.438 volt. And current is 0.5 ampere. Now I will take a green LED. This also, bigger terminal, bigger one is anode. This green LED is glowing. Forward drop is 1.538 volt. This is in millivolt. Left side what is shown is millivolt. Current is 0.47 milliampere. Now I will check this big LED, 5mm LED. Here also same, big terminal, big wire is anode, smaller one is cathode. It is glowing, it is working. Drop is 1.46 volt at the current of 0.495 milliampere. I have two transistor, one NPN, one PNP. In NPN base is positive. In PNP, emitter is positive. So, first I will take NPN and connect base to positive. It comes 745 millivolt at 0.932 milliampere. Now I will take other one. Here this emitter will be connected to positive. Another terminal here. This comes 731 millivolt at 0.94. Remember that in PNP, emitter is positive. Now I will measure the HFE of both the transistor. I am measuring HFE for NPN transistor. The switch position has been kept at HFE. Now, these are the point where we connect the transistor. There are two, one is NPN, one is PNP. So because I am checking NPN, I will connect here. And this is collector, base, emitter. So we will connect our transistors, collector, base here, base, emitter, like this. It is showing 461, HFE is 461. Now we will measure HFE of PNP. This PNP transistor connected here. Because PNP is written here, this PNP. And terminal EBC is written. So emitter will go to E, B will go to B, and collector will go to C. And switch position HFE. HFE is coming 313. So for measuring HFE, there is a separate terminals and transistor are connected like this. If you like my video, then please press like button and subscribe.